or get into the presence, into the threshold of this word, that they will get the full grasp of it.
Amen.
That's what God is ready for now. Thank you. To use you. Sit down. To use you. The Lord revealed unto us 1.5 million visionaries.
Hallelujah.
That is raising up to shake the earth. Hallelujah. Did you know what one of the, it came to my attention that one of the mightiest men of God on the earth right now came on the internet. One of the mightiest preachers I ever heard. But he came on the internet and he was crying. And he said, some folks came to him and said, why nobody prophesied COVID? And he was crying.
Yes.
He was crying. He was crying. Now, his crying was not right. His statement was not right. But let me tell you what was right. The word vision, the word prophet, the word revelation, because that is the word now.
Come to me.
Come on, I'm not putting him down. I don't put down ministers easy, like you love to do. I don't do it easy, because God raised me to raise them up. You know me, nobody. If they will listen, if they will pay attention to the prophetic, God will raise them up.
Amen.
What I love, even though he was wrong, and I may not have the time tonight to show you why he's wrong, I may give you later. But he had the right word. The word was prophet. The word was prophecy. His worry was about prophecy. His worry was about lack of prophecy, because much of the body of Christ want to behave as if they can do without prophecy. We preach our storm. We preach our theology. We preach now, my God, that the word is in our toes. So prophecy, the word of God, the revelation of God, is the ark.
Yes.
It's not just good preaching. They were doing good preaching in New Orleans.
Yes.
A few years ago, Sunday service was hot. The choir was singing well. They were doing their, whatever they were doing. 24 hours, your audience was under water. By weekend, over 3,000 was dead. What was missing? What was missing?
Prophecy.
Not talking to me. What was missing?
Prophecy.
So I thank God that that man of God at least have the word. Hallelujah. The word. You may come to this church and we may not do everything perfectly. The choir maybe can sing better, maybe whatever it is. But listen to me. What's the key word? You don't want to talk to me. You don't want to talk to me. Because you're criticizing the choir, so you don't want to talk to me. Glory to God. The key word.
Prophecy.
It's not easy to prophesy.
Amen.
I'm making it like it doesn't easy right now. But it is the word.
Yes.
It's not easy to raise children. Am I right, Mama? But you better raise them.
Exactly.
Are you being satisfied? It's not easy to prophesy. But it does. Hallelujah. Prophecy. But God.
Hallelujah.
And when you get a chance to be in the presence of chapter 12, verse 10. He said, by the prophet, I took you out of Egypt. Somebody work with me.
Yeah.
And in verse 13, he said, of Hosea 12, by a prophet, I will preserve you. Don't let nobody get around you. Don't let them trick you. Don't let them give you a nice church. Come on, somebody. Impressive church. And that's no word from God. You may be a church of no microphone. Joel 2 and verse 20. In the last days, I'll pour out. Come on, someone say last days. Someone say last days. I'll pour off my spirit. For God knows that we can't do without it. Come on, don't be scared of prophecy because they prophesy wrong about the president. Don't be scared of prophecy.
Amen.
At least those men where they must use the word. Some will criticize them, though it's as far as them.
Amen.
Anybody can criticize a prophet who miss. They don't want to talk to you. You better put your watch in the bucket. Come on, somebody. Anybody can do videos. Oh, you prophesy and miss.
Amen.
Oh, you never prophesy.
Yes. Come on.
Smarter than that. He knows he must save his life. So when he gives a prophecy, he gives it in prayer.
When the things happen, they cannot be withdrawn.
Second Chronicles 36, verse 15. God said he sent prophets because of his compassion for mankind. But in verse 16 of Second Chronicles 36, he said they despise the prophets and misuse his words and mock his messengers until the wrath of God came upon the people till there was no remedy. Those folks who rise up against prophets right now, they don't know what they're playing with. Ask God, that prophet make a mistake. Ask God to help him. Ask God to deliver him. Ask God to cause him to repent and turn around. And thank God, it's not the Old Testament. Because of the old time, you'll be dead. But it's New Testament. And you are also enjoying New Testament.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord.
Father, in your hand, I place every man, every woman, every girl, every boy, in this room. As Lord, we step into the low tide of the revival. We're not simple folks. Only wait until everybody is clapping, then we clap and have less impact. But while the tide is low, the real tide of revival, yes, Lord, it's the real revival, but the tide is just starting. It's low. It's just at the anchor. It's just on the feet. And it's coming up, Lord. Here, these have come. Some have traveled from far, traveled from other country, other state, other part of Florida. My God, to be here, Lord, I pray that you'll sanctify them. Sanctify their feet. Sanctify their hands. Sanctify their mind. Sanctify their spirit. Yes, Lord, release upon them the prophetic anointing. Release upon them the anointing of a visionary to see in the spirit. Lord, give them wisdom, knowledge, understanding. Give them word of knowledge. Give them word of wisdom. Give them word of counsel. Give them word of mind.
Thank you, Lord.
Everyone pray for me right now, Jesus.
Jesus.
I come to you. I realize, Lord, to be used by you, I have to be a pure vessel. I have to be sanctified. So, Lord, I ask you, wash me, Lord. Cleanse me, Lord, of every sin in my life. Wash me, Lord, of being out of your will. And, Lord, I come to you right now. Thank you, Lord, for ordering my steps. I can be here tonight. And Lord, I receive the prophetic anointing. Lord, I receive the visionary anointing upon me right now. My mind, my spirit, my body, my walk, my talk, my thinking, my ministry. In the name of Jesus, I receive the visionary, the prophetic anointing upon my life. Use me, Lord. Use me, Lord. Use me, Lord. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it. In the name of Jesus, I receive it. Now! In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 And when this conference was revealed, it wasn't revealed by me. And they would think that maybe Bishop, he always wanted to have revival, so. But God allowed a little lady to reveal it. And here what she said. She said it will be manifested in 2 weeks. She said it will be immediate. Yeah, that's what she said. And she said, these young women started to give up flyers fast. That's what we did. She said, in no time. Can you promote the conference in 2 weeks? That's crazy. Yeah. But yours, she also said there's a brother who won't show. Oh my God, my God. Ford says, oh, I'm going to bring her here, let you speak for her. This is the brother. This is the brother. This is the brother. Father, in your mighty hand, I place your son. servant, your vessel, who you have sent in revival, Lord. What if we have not continued, Lord? What if we have gone by the flesh? God, we have to give an account. Because you look for a man to stand in the gap. Lord, here is a man. Lord, I pray for the purpose for which you have revealed this brother. Let it be fulfilled. Use him, Lord. Raise him up, Lord, to be a mighty warrior, a mighty vessel for this revival to be used by God. I release the anointing, the prophetic anointing, revelation anointing upon this world. I cover my name, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke every block of the devil. Every attack of the enemy that will come against him from fulfilling your will in his life. And I cover him under the blood right now, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. And Lord, I order his feet, because your words are the steps of good men are ordered by the Lord. Somebody say, Jesus, God bless you, my brother. God bless you, my brother.